press about divorce reform. Tell me a little bit about the background to that.
Yeah, it's the campaign for what we call, in shorthand, no-fault divorce. And in fact, in the mid-90s, we had an Act of Parliament that would have allowed no-fault divorce, but it never went anywhere and it eventually got scrapped. But the campaign has been going on ever since then. I was chair of resolution in the mid-90s when we had it, and I thought that I would come back and do the job again in 2016 because of that unfinished business. So at the moment we've got a divorce system which encourages people effectively to blame each other to get a divorce unless you want to wait 2 years by agreement or 5 years if there's no agreement. And that's just, it's barbaric really, it doesn't make any sense, it doesn't help people. So that campaign has been going on, and in the last year or two there's been a real momentum for change caused by two things really. First of all, a case called Owens, which went all the way to the Supreme Court, and in which Mills and Reeve were involved. And also some really good research from Professor Liz Trinder and colleagues at Exeter University, which looked at public responses to the current divorce process, as well as the legal experience from family lawyers like you and me.
So the Owens case you mentioned, and as you say, it had a lot of coverage, but what were the key points arising out of that case? Why did that prompt the case for reform?
Well, Mrs. Owens wanted a divorce. She said the marriage had broken down irretrievably, but Mr. Owens blocked it. Mrs. Owens went for a behaviour divorce petition. Mr. Owens defended it. Really unusual. Very few divorces are defended. But it went to a trial, which is what happened, before a judge. And the judge heard the evidence and didn't feel that, basically, it was strong enough under our existing law to grant Teenie Owens her divorce. So she appealed that to the Court of Appeal. They didn't feel able to interfere with the judge's decision, and then she appealed to the Supreme Court. And again, the Supreme Court, although I think all of the other judges might well have personally granted it if they'd been hearing it first time round, they didn't feel under our appeal process that they could interfere with that judge's decision. So Mrs. Owens is blocked from getting her divorce until February 2020, when she can start again on 5 years, even though everybody in the case, including all the judges, accepted that the marriage had broken down effectively.
And we were there as part of that case, weren't we? So there were a couple of ways that you were involved. One was as chair of resolution, I think, yeah. And then also Mills and Reeve were instructed in that regard. Is
yeah.
that right?
Resolution applied to intervene in the Supreme Court in support of Mrs. Owens' case, but also because there was that wider interest in the need for reform to get rid of this blame game, if you like. And so we were given permission to intervene with written submissions. And when it came to who should represent resolution, I offered Mills and Reeve my natural personal connection. And also because as a firm, we're so committed to try to help our clients find a better way to divorce. And therefore, we had the privilege of being in the Supreme Court making those submissions. Unfortunately, the Supreme Court didn't grant the divorce, but nevertheless, we were part of this really important drive for change.
And the positive thing that came out of that, as you mentioned, plus the Professor Trinder research, so the Owens case and that research, meant that the government then launched a consultation in terms of changing the law, consideration around changing the law, which I think ended at the end of last year. And now we've got some recommendations for a change in the law. Can you just talk us through what those changes would be?
Yeah, instead of having five sort of sub-grounds, if you like, that you can prove irretrievable breakdown on, you will now have a notification system. So one of the couple, and importantly, they can do it together as well as an alternative, say that they think the marriage is over. If at the end of a six-month period they're still of that view, or one of them is still of that view, there will be a divorce. There'll be no ability to defend. There'll be no option to apportion blame. So it's much more constructive. It's much more future-focused. It helps people concentrate on the arrangements for the children, most importantly, and their finances as a separate couple rather than looking back on the past. So really important. I think also, Caitlin, it's important for the way that we work with clients.
Absolutely.
And so you might, you know, you would say something about what we think it means to our clients and the approach that we take at Mills and Reeve.
Well, I think it'll help take the heat out of it. I think it'll help take the heat out of a divorce. And as you say, most of the time when people come to see us, actually they're at a stage where they've come to the very sad conclusion that their marriage is over. And the last thing they want to do is to have to look back and make some sort of allegation of fault, whether strong enough to get through the court process and to be strong enough legally, but equally not so strong as to raise the levels of acrimony again. And so actually it will enable people, most people, to go about the divorce in the way that they want. It won't simplify divorce. Divorce is never easy. But it will, I think, more closely accord with both what clients want and what clients need at that particular point in time.
So it's really positive for our,
absolutely,
you know, for those of us, so many of us in Mills and Reeve nationally, who are mediators, collaborative practitioners, and when we're actually representing people, even in court proceedings,
absolutely,
it means that our focus is on trying to get a settlement, trying to encourage people to find a way through this.
Absolutely.
And so this change in the divorce process is a really positive thing for our approach and for our commitment to that constructive approach.
Absolutely, and for our clients. I suppose the only other thing to say is that at the moment we don't know when the change is going to come in.
That's right.
So it's been announced that the change is going to come when there's some time, legislative time.
Mm.
I think my understanding is that the current Justice Secretary is very keen on it.
He is, yes.
But at the moment we don't have a date either for when the legislation will be brought before Parliament or when it will then be enacted and then when it will come into effect. So we're still stuck with the same old law at the moment, but it's watch this space for the future. And when it does come in, I agree with you, I think it will be very positive for all sorts of different clients, whatever their circumstance, and our ability to help them.
Really, absolutely.
Thank you.